Tim Tebow said, the church is not about the do's and the don'ts, and that's what it's become. A lot of, you can't do this, you can't do that. He said, the church is about the done's, what Jesus has already done, and the light that he's already set us up with. I was like, yo, that's dope right there. It's not the do's and the don'ts, it's what he's already done.
You ready? All right.
Hey, I want to go back though, see, because right as you're talking, like I'm realizing how either brainwashing is so deep, because deep, everything bro. We were taught, we had to depend on something external to make that happen.
Yeah.
Everything that we were taught said you had to depend on some employer, like you had to depend on something, the lottery, it was all external. What you're saying now is people need to go internal, and to East Point, bro, we never knew that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We Absolutely. Never knew that. Mm-hmm. So now it's just like you're asking me to do something, bro, that's so foreign to me. Like how, where, when, why? I don't know. You see what I'm saying? We were literally in a society that taught us we had to depend on somebody else for everything.
Every single thing. Especially if you come from the Midwest.
Yeah, and they created it. And what we're learning is today, they did that on purpose.
On purpose.
No question.
Because if you unlock that, then you know how to go get it. Now you're playing in their game.
Right. Yeah. But to the dude in prison, the beautiful thing, and you always say simplify it, the way you get out of it is you have to be disrupted. Mm-hmm. So there has to be some disruption. So by him going to jail, he had an opportunity to get a disruption, saying, okay, I was doing it this way, but they actually provided. It's like you don't even get it. They set you up to be able to get the Ferrari.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They set you up. Mm-hmm. And they set you up to only do it for so long.
Right.
Because now they could come in, set you up,
yep.
And now they could come in and be like, no, you're doing X, Y, and Z, you're going to jail. Now you got to pay for a lawyer. Now you got to pay for court fees. Now you got to pay while you're in jail. Because jail is a business.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So that I'm making $40,000, $50,000 off of each one of y'all a year. Mm-hmm. Somebody owns the prison. People think like a prison is like owned by the state. No,
Christ
it's a person
owned,
that owns it. Like he owned Taco Bell.
It's crazy.
He owned the prison.
And I did research and they found that they decide where to put prisons based on your education level in the city around third grade.
Right. So they already know when you're in the third grade, you're going to jail.
Yeah.
That's why when I go to these elementary schools and they're like, why are you so passionate? I'm like, well, I got to be more passionate with the first grader than I do with the 12th grader.
Right.
Because by the 12th grade, you either can read or you can't.
Yeah.
I could catch you in the first grade or second grade. I could scare you and make you do it. So here's the deal. So number one, it has to be a disruption. Like, you got to get out of the system long enough to know you were in the system.
Yeah, that's good.
You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You got to know you was in the system.
Yeah.
So when Maul was coming at me, I'm like, Maul, I don't know about real estate, but I know off the cuff.
Mm-hmm.
I go get some J's right now. I'm about to get more affirmation, and I'm going to get this crib.
Yep. Because
if I go get the crib, people are going to be, oh, you ain't got cribs with money. Now, that's going to hurt me. Why? Because another part of how they set this whole thing up is caring what other people think.
Yeah.
So a lot of people don't want to talk about you grown, but still you trapped because you're making decisions based on, man, I had a conversation, I don't even know if I should say this out loud.
Mm.
So I had a conversation with Chuck had posted something. Again, I don't know if it's the truth, it's not the truth, but this kid wrote about
it's on the internet. It's got to be true.
Right. This kid wrote a book about being a monk. And so they're saying, I don't know who it was exactly, but they were saying that he didn't really go and spend the time with the monks. Right? Mm-hmm. So Jalen was like, you know, like, Dad, I just read his book. And so he was kind of concerned, like, he didn't even really go. I was like, well, it don't matter if you went to go see the monks or not. Did the information...
exactly, right.
Like, was the information dope that you read?
Yeah.
Right. Can you apply it?
Yeah.
He was like, yeah. He was like, man, Dad, that's crazy though. What happened to my man? You know, because, you know, how people going to look at him. I said, let me say this to you. 72 million people didn't like Donald Trump. But 71 million did.
Hmm.
So that first, this time he won, I don't know what the numbers was, but he won. Second time, he barely lost to Biden by about a million votes. Mm-hmm. I said, son, now we about to run up to another presidency where it's back to, It's the thrill in vanilla.
Yeah. Oh,
it's the thrill in vanilla.
Not vanilla.
We about to run this.
Vanilla, exactly.
We about to run up.
Freudian slip.
I said, son, 70-something million people can't stand Donald Trump. He's still running for president. Mm. I said, it don't matter what people think, son.
Don't.
It don't matter. He running for president. When he first ran, you thought, there's no way possible. This dude is a entertainer. He a business person. He got a TV show. Like, nobody was taking him serious. Yep. He president of the United States of America. Period, bro. Didn't go through none of the stuff that you get programmed to go through to be president. Uh-huh. He didn't go to none of them schools. He wasn't no senator. He wasn't none of that.
None of that.
Whatever Barack them did, Clinton did, Bush, whatever they, he didn't do that. He did not follow that programming. He did his own thing. So I told my son, I said, here's what I want you to understand. You will never blow up until you get out of your head what people think about what you do is important.
Yep.
That's the number two thing system they set up, that you can't make a decision independent of what the people closest you think who program. Mm-hmm. So now I got to talk. I got to fight with you about this programming that you got programmed. I got out of it. And this is why Harriet Tubman carried a shotgun. That's why she carried a shotgun.
Yep.
Because she said, I saved hundreds, but I could have saved thousands of more if they knew they were enslaved. She's like, they didn't know they were enslaved. So I got the ones that kind of figured it out, but I had to carry a shotgun because halfway going, they talking about turning around.
Yeah.
And she was like, yo, if you turn around, you're going to get me caught. No. So I got to kill you. So she said, I never carried the shotgun for my enemy. I carried it for my own people. Bro, imagine that. She said, I never had no plans on shooting. It was too many of them. I couldn't outshoot them. I bought it for the super Negro. I bought it for the super Negro. You know what I'm saying? Who halfway,
wow.
who more wants to be free, but the programming keeps saying.
Programming strong.
Get them J's.
The programming is strong.
Get them J's.
It's strong.
Get that car. Bruh, you buying a car you can't afford and putting sound system in. Why? Because we've been programmed not to really do something, but we've been programmed to get that high that you get in the community when you bring. Bro, I don't care what nobody says.
I ain't gonna lie, that's a good feeling. Bro, you get a new whip, put some beats in.
Now look,
but it's temporal. It goes away so fast.
You get your
faces
long queued up. Bye, as soon as you pass by the lady.
You already said temporal. I said it's a bunch of temporals.
Oh, yeah.
It's a bunch of little small ones.
Keep finding more temporary. Bro,
Maul, I don't know if y'all have ever done this before.
Ooh.
You ever gone into a school to speak and you go into the classroom and you look at the kids' shoes?
Yeah.
Oh, bro.
Yeah.
Bruh. It's about 50 brands of shoes. You go into a classroom, I swear to you, only one or two kids ain't wearing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Whole school on reduced lunch.
Whole school on reduced lunch. Everybody's wearing.
And it ain't the kid, it's the parents. It's
the parents. Because, well,
they putting it in the kids.
Absolutely.
I'm talking about.
Right. Yeah. But again, this ain't poverty shaming by no means, because I think parents also feel like, man, I want my kids to, you know,
not experience.
Because, right, I'm saying, because of the programming that they had,
right?
It's like, I'm going to do everything I can to get my kids these J's so they don't feel inferior the way I felt. Or, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so now it's this competition about having them have the appearance of doing well, or I got the shoe. And I understand it, but how, I guess, man, it's on us. And I tell Maul all the time, the Black Dave Ramsey, as I like to call him.
Oh.
But I'm saying, Maul has a different way of thinking about money and generational wealth. Like, bro, be honest. Before Maul came in the circle, we were talking about money and, like, making money.
Yeah.
But we weren't never talking about investing. We were never talking about real estate. We weren't talking about generational wealth.
We weren't executing.
I definitely didn't have no trust. Like, bro, I got a trust.
I didn't have no trust, bro.
Huh?
I didn't have no trust, bro.
That's what I'm saying. I got a whole trust.
I didn't even understand what a trust was. Let me be real with you.
Oh, bro, I thought a will. I didn't have a will either, right. But I thought a will was the way.
Enough.
Yeah, and, like, so, again, but I'm saying, this is why I'm telling you, and I tell you all the time, man, okay, I'm say it like this. The same way that they living out loud, it's like, dog, we got to go the other way.
Other way.
So I was saying that even, like, you know, I've been doing these Instagram videos with with my kids and my wife. And somebody was like, man, see, you like coming out a little bit more on the internet. And I was like, you know what? I'm a more private person, and I really was always kind of like, I want my wife and my kids. And like, you know, I'm just a little bit more private than I ain't, whatever. And I promise you, bro, God convicted me and was like, how dare you? Like, you a black man in America who got a fantastic relationship with your wife. Mm. You and your kids, y'all be playing. Like, you need to show that to the world, because guess what? They showing Blueface and his girl on a reg. Whether you want to see it or not, they going to force that on them kids. Yeah. They forcing that on you. Wow. And so you going to keep your little stuff hidden for your own sake? Oof. When them is my people you supposed to be looking out for? So again, the same way I say that, I say, bruh, our people, we don't understand. Like the stuff we talking about, that's not even understood in the community. So it's a vicious cycle that keep on repeating to where I'm on reduced lunch with a $250 pair of shoes.
Yeah.
And my people is struggling. And I see it all the time. Especially, we talked about it. Candace was talking about, she was like, in Detroit, she was like, yo, you could live in, imagine you living in a $30,000 ran down crib, and they buying their kids Cartier glasses to go to school.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Ferragamo shoes, and like we really on that. So I'm saying, who is the voice of our generation telling them this is the way? And I'm asking a question right now. Mm-hmm. Who is it? I'm saying, who black right now?
Well, I can name a few.
I'm saying, it's a few people that's trying, but I'm saying, are they penetrating the community? Are they in the communities?
Well, I want to say this.
The people we talking about ain't necessarily connecting with that.
Yeah, and I'm going to say why. I think we have to do a better job of not just teaching the principles more and living the principles, but also perpetuating the programming. Mm. You feel me? And that's what I try my hardest not to do.
Yeah, I got
to
take... Give me my Reeboks. Let me take these J's off. I'm perpetuating. No, and I'm
just
joking.
Being real.
Because
I'm not joking.
And nobody's saying don't have nice... No, stuff. Like, there's an order of operations. Yes, you know what I'm saying? It's an order of operations.
What happens is we teach our ancestors principles, but sometimes we mix them, you know, with the programming. And we have to be careful. So it doesn't mean God doesn't want me to be in California and enjoying that life. That's not what it means. But I can't make it as if, Maul, I can't make it as if this life, meaning money, is why I am where I am. Like I can't, you know, be in the Rolls Royce like, yo, look at me.
Yeah.
It's like, you know how many of our ancestors died to position us to be where we are right now. So I can't take the car and elevate the car above my ancestors. I can't elevate it above God.
Yeah.
I have to keep it in this proper perspective. And I think sometimes what we do is we're showing people, hey, if you get six cars that are, you know, exotic European luxury vehicles, your marriage is going to be, said, bro, that don't got nothing to do with your marriage. And you should be whatever you put in your car in terms of care, you should be putting that in your marriage. But we're not teaching that. We're teaching you could get the money. You know what I'm saying? And so then we go after the money. Sometimes we get it, sometimes we don't. But then we lose our entire family. You know, and when you look at other communities, they don't have the same divorce rate. Yeah. They don't have the same daddy not in their life, whatever, because they're not just going after money. I told C, I was like, bro, we got to do this, bro. We got a church. We got to do this, bro. Like, the Disney is not about taking these kids, you know, on no trip. Because somebody was like, well, Moni, you know, me and Moni got a great relationship together. We both went to Oakwood, same time. You know, Moni probably went a year before me. She went when I should have went, okay?
When did she graduate compared to when you graduated?
Well, both 12 years, but she became a doctor. We both was on the 12-year plan, Mark.
Well, yeah.
Both was on the 12-year plan.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Slightly different.
You know what
outcome.
I'm saying? We just had different
she
outcomes.
Her residency.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? But she had pulled me to the side, Mark, because sometimes when you don't speak poverty in a community of poverty, I want to make sure people caught that. When you don't speak poverty, but you're amongst poverty mindsets. Yeah. So while Moni got bread, Moni is super sensitive to the people in the room. And she's like, yo, did you hear what you said? And I was like, yeah, I heard what I said. She was like, did you mean to say it? I said, yeah. Because she know I said Rosa Parks. And you know what I said? But she was making sure.
Dr. King.
She said, you said staying in an Airbnb when you go to Disney is ghetto. Mm. And I said, I did. Mm-hmm. But I was talking about in the context of what we're doing.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
I said, I'm
because they're not gonna get the full experience.
Right. I said, I'm not talking about you and your family wanting to go to Disney,
right.
And you want to go stay in the Airbnb,
right.
And then you want to drive to go to Disney. I said, that's not what I was talking about. We're talking about exposure. This is an exposure trip.
Right.
This ain't Disney.
Yeah.
This is an exposure trip. So they all their life they've been bust.
Mm.
Their whole life we. Growing up, we was bust.
Always.
Our whole life, we was bust.
Yep.
Wherever you want to go to a better school, you get bust over there.
Yep.
Or you want to go downtown Detroit, they don't put us in a luxury van. Mm-mm. They don't put us in one of them nice limos. They put us in a yellow bus everywhere we go.
Yep.
So when we pull up, whether it's a basketball tournament, whatever, we're in a yellow bus. I was like, we're not doing that. That's ghetto. They're going to stay on the property. They're going to wake up at Disney.
Yep.
They're going to walk out the hotel. They're going to eat breakfast with the princes.
Yep.
They're going to, all them little figures that they see on TV, they're going to eat lunch with them.
Yep.
They're going to go to the Capitol and sit up top and eat steaks while they watch the fireworks. Why? Because everybody else kids get to do it.
Yep. All right, here's a quick test for you. How many subscriptions do you have active right this moment? It's probably a bit more than you think, but you're not alone. Did you know that over 75% of people have subscriptions that they've actually forgotten about? Between the streaming services, fitness apps, delivery services, guys, it's never ending. But thanks to Rocket Money, you can take control of your spending and not waste money on those things that you don't use. Rocket Money is a personal finance app that finds and cancels your unwanted subscriptions, monitors your spending, and helps lower your bills so that you can grow your savings. With Rocket Money, you have full control over your subscriptions and a clear view of your expenses. You can see all of your subscriptions in one place, and if there's something that you don't want, Rocket Money can help you cancel it with just a few taps. The dashboard even shows you this month's spending compared to last month, so you can clearly see your spending habits. Plus, they help you create a custom budget and keep your spending on track. Rocket Money will even try to negotiate lower bills for you guys by up to 20%, and all you have to do is submit a photo of that bill, and Rocket Money takes care of the rest. They'll deal with the customer service for you. Rocket Money has over 5 million users and has saved a total of 500 million in canceled subscriptions, saving members up to $740 a year when using all of the app's features. Stop wasting money on things you don't use. Cancel your unwanted subscriptions by going to rocketmoney.com/success. That's rocketmoney.com/success. rocketmoney.com/success.
But we always taught to stay, that's wasteful. Why you doing that? Oh, y'all should be staying at the Airbnb and make bag lunch and then get the kids a little sandwich with the grapes in it.
But meanwhile, when I go to Disney
and
I see the kids in the princess outfit,
but we
got on J's. I'm like, take that junk off right now and put on the $400 princess so you can feel like you belong here.
Bro, I'm almost to tears because there's a part of me that I'm hearing you, but... Bro, that's so much work to do.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, like, just to be real, like, this one exposure compared to all the rest of crap that we deal in, bro, it's a lot of work to do.
It is.
It's you see what I'm saying? Like, this one experience is going to be dope.
Yeah.
But, bro, your kids still come back to this.
And that's what I'm saying, what I said to C. Yo, we got a church.
Wow.
We got to stop doing church. Yeah. And we got to create a community like that.
But how do you, when you say it's a lot of work to do, when I go into a property, Carl, it's a lot, bro. Right? It's a lot. And even like this development that we're about to do, I can't start with the light fixtures. I can't start with what color paint.
Yeah.
I can't start with...
My bad, see.
I got to start with the foundation, bruh. I got to start with the foundation. And once you start with the foundation, everything else is stacked.
Oh, no question.
It stacks on top of that. So even with these kids, you go back to what E's saying, you got to gut out the mindset.
Yeah.
You got to revamp that mindset.
No question.
That's the first thing you got to do. And how do you do it? What's the quickest way? You got to expose them and first show
them.
Full
immersion.
You got to show them. You got to shock them.
Yeah.
And that's what exposure do, bro. I'm telling you, when I went, I didn't, look, Jamal, I didn't, I always said I wanted to be rich. I always wanted to be a millionaire.
Yeah.
But I still didn't even know what that really was until I got exposed to it. Yeah. When I saw my boy and all these other guys, and I, they houses smelled different.
Yeah.
It didn't smell like fried chicken or pork chop. No, you know what I'm saying?
No, you just
know what it smell like. Money.
It just smelled I'm just different, saying, bro. It was
leather.
You know, we don't fry fish in San Diego.
Nobody fry. I ain't never fried food in my house, bro. It was just different. And I said, man.
Yeah.
I remember like it was yesterday, bro. Mm. I had to come back home and try to show people. I knew my people were gonna never go there.
Yeah.
So I had to bring it back to them. And then I start bringing friends with me, man. Vince, Tommy, I start bringing my friends with me because they went. I'm like, man, y'all got to believe because I start sounding crazy.
Yeah.
I'm coming back to work. Like, man,
that's
we got to.
I said.
We got to.
I'm talking wealth in a poverty language. Like, you're talking to people who speak poverty and you're talking wealth.
So what E doing is the same thing I did years ago, right? You're bringing the people to the exposure.
Yeah.
Because when you come back and try to tell them about it, they can't even understand what you're saying, bro.
We can't. But I told C, so what we got to do is create traditions.
There it is.
I was like, yo, see, we can't.
There it is.
Just whatever. It's like every year we do this. Every August we do this. Every Christmas we do this. It's like, bruh, my boy, my son's roommate in college, you know, and I always told Boog, like, again, it's that thing we talked about on the last podcast. It's that, it's like, Boog, I get it, but it's almost like, bruh, even in our community, it's so crazy. You got to be one type of black. Mm-hmm. You feel me? It's like you look at Fresh Prince. I just tell people all the time, like, I never watched Fresh Prince, bro. Like, I wasn't on that. I it was nothing about Fresh Prince that I saw that I was like, oh, this is dope. I just didn't. Martin, I watched Martin, bro. I just felt like Martin was.
Come on, man. Fresh Prince, though. We're not going to relax.
Relax. Look, I'm just saying.
No, I love Martin, too. No,
I'm not saying it was one of the best shows because Will ain't no joke. So Will's mind, even the fact that he thought to do that is dope because he started exposing our kids to wealth.
To wealth.
So Beverly Hills, that was wealth. Yeah. Like, he was genius. But I'm saying I was programmed to enjoy Martin. I wasn't when I saw Carlton them, I wasn't like, I'm just being real, I didn't watch
it. You didn't understand it.
The only thing I liked was the relationship between Uncle Phil and Will. Like, that's what I liked. His cousins or whatever, I didn't really get into it. Like, I might have saw three episodes. I saw all Martin. Right to this day,
you only saw three.
I saw three episodes, bro.
That's why he can't appreciate it the same way.
I saw three episodes, bro. I was like, and those were the ones I saw when they would show like the best of, you know, the whatever. But
Did you watch Fresh Prince?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So I say that to say, but those traditions you can even see in their family.
Yeah.
They had those, so I realized in other communities there were traditions.
That's
so
good,
I'm like, okay, y'all know I grew up. You know, of course, in the deep, but my parents moved to Southfield, and we lived on 12 Mile Lhasa, and that was this is before I even really knew, you know, the Bible like that, and before I really became, you know, deep into, you know, Adventism, going to Oakwood. Mm-hmm. But our community was a Jewish community. So on Friday night, bruh, crazy.
Shut it down.
Bruh, crazy, bruh.
Shut it
Man,
down.
Man, you gotta see it, Ma. I'm living in the neighborhood. It's a Jewish community. Friday night, bro, you hear, doo-doo! You hear the horn, bro. You see them all come out with their garb on, and they all walk into the synagogue, bro. Crazy, bro. Crazy. Saturday, you see them walk into the synagogue. Saturday night, you see the sun coming down. They all in it, bro. Huge synagogue in the neighborhood, bro. I'm from the D, bro. We got these little crazy little storefront churches. They synagogues was massive, and they built everything around it. You know, you got your stores, the bagels. I wasn't eating bagels, but I went to school bagels, and I saw it, and then that's when I got turned on to, you know, all the rituals that went with it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like all of the, you know, the Passover and they have been doing this for thousands of years. Bro, I got a good friend. I don't know if you remember Michael Engler from New York.
Mm-hmm.
Ma, listen to me. I'm not playing, Ma. his father is like one of the big, has one of the big hedge funds, whatever. His son. So he called me once and was like, E, yeah, I just got back from Israel. And I was like, oh, for real? He's like, yeah, I went to go see my uncle. Went to his grave. And I was like, oh, okay. Your uncle just passed? He was like, no, he been dead for a while. I was like, oh, okay, what's your uncle name? He's like, Abraham.
Oh, wow.
I said,
like,
what?
Like,
I said, Abraham, like, Abraham in the Bible? He was like, oh, yeah.
Once we call him Abe.
Bruh, he was talking like Abraham.
Wow.
Bruh, he was like, yeah, we went to go to temple. And he was breaking it down. He's like, yeah, so if you come from, give me the names again, Carl, I don't want to mess up. Ishmael, or if you come from
Isaac,
you go to a different, so Ishmael people.
Why you always ask Carl for help with the Bible, bro? I know a little, I knew that.
I'm sorry.
He just knows. I've been in that environment just a little longer. That's all.
Y'all better than everybody.
You notice how they ask you though whenever you're playing like a rap song?
Yeah.
Who's that? See?
Discrimination. Carl, help me out. What's the name of that? Yeah, exactly.
Don't lose your thought. But
I'm Glorilla.
For all my media people, everybody's familiar with B&H Photo, right. Huge, you know, media store.
Yeah.
Bro, Jewish owned.
Yeah.
You can't order on Sabbath.
You can't order, bro. That's
crazy.
Bro,
they shut it down. So I'm going back to what you're thinking again. I literally started over reading the Bible, first couple of books of the Bible, and they talk about, what you're saying is, it's deep, but it's deeper because, like, that was God's design.
Yeah.
There were 7 festivals that he told the Israelites, when I bring y'all out of Egypt,
yeah,
y'all gonna keep the Sabbath, the Festival of Weeks, the Festival of Shelters, the Passover. Bro, 7 of them. That's why my man in 2020, whatever, talking
he's
to you,
still doing it,
could
more.
Tell you all about that.
And that's how
they still
do
it.
Day, and the reason why I realized we got to do it is because when you lose the Chiefs, if you don't have it, you lose
the community. The whole culture.
You lose everything. So we have to have, like, they got to know Disney. So this is what I was going to say.
Wow.
So Jalen's roommate, you know, his father's part owner of the Milwaukee Bucks and owns some kind of, like, I don't know, steel mill, whatever, like some type of industry. His father passed it down to him. So every year, he gives his sons like thousands and thousands of dollars to donate to whatever cause they want to do. So for me, like, I'm learning these traditions. So I'm like, okay, Jalen and Jada, y'all need to pick, you know, and don't be biased. Like, don't do your homegirl because it's your homegirl or your homeboy. Like, really think it through. So I'm like, yo, I see what he's doing. It's a tradition.
Wow.
It's like, here go thousands of dollars. Go find a cause so that when the father leaves this earth, his sons still know it's not just about y'all.
Yeah.
A portion of our money has to go back. And so I'm like, Boog, all this time, this is who you should have been with. And they cool because they, whatever, but he's white, right? So but they cool, but Jay, I felt like, always felt like he got to be, you know, mm-hmm, like Marty Marr.
Right.
And it's like, you the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, mm-hmm, period. Wow. You know what I'm saying? Like, it is what it is.
Yeah.
You can try to Marty Marr all you want to, and I know why you want to do it, because when you Marty Marr, there's an acceptance you get from,
yep,
when you Fresh Prince. Will wasn't going back. Remember when Will would go back? They was like,
they spun him around their head.
Bruh, they like, get your butt up out of here. Like, you ain't even.
You saw the intro though, for sure.
Yeah, y'all, no question. No question. Yeah. But I'm just saying, Ma, so for the church, I told C, yo, we got to create these traditions. We got to explain why we doing what we doing. And they got to know when you get up in the morning, you know, or late at night, we get to go to some parks because we own campus, and we get to go start. I think campus
is
7 o'clock.
What a novel concept!
Earlier than
everybody. Yeah, we get
else
to go at 7 o'clock.
Now
in the
you
morning
gotta wait 2 hours.
Right, absolutely.
Yep. As soon as y'all get back, we from the park, we're gonna have a good time. I can't do the Disney.
Yeah, I can't.
I'm dead. Yeah.
But even
I'm
with that,
old, bro.
The reason why he can't do it because he's been there about 4 times.
Right.
Literally this year. Already this year. This year.
Yeah. Yeah. So. Wow. Yeah.
But no. But yeah, what a novel concept having the church be looked at as some place the kids actually want to go.
Want to go.
No, I'm just saying, like, how long has it been since, like, kids was, like, geeked up about, and not just, like, a trip, but just, like, church being dope. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, so I know some of y'all out there may got some dope church that the kids want to go to, but when I came up, it was like, we got to go to church. Like, oh, my God. You know what I mean? Like, churches should be somewhere where these kids, you know, so, you know, shout out to E for changing the culture around that. Because,
yeah. Bruh, I'm just saying, man, just being around, you know, the collective, it's like, we can change this. Like, I believe in my heart. So that's why I'm trying to tell everybody that's in our community that's doing well, don't try to make it about, like, it's okay to have stuff, but don't create a golden calf out of the stuff.
Yeah.
And have people worshiping the, Moses is like, what are y'all doing? Like, God created the gold and the calf, and y'all sitting here worshiping something that he created instead of worshiping the person that created the thing itself. Like, it don't even make sense. It's not, I was up there, I didn't came down, I've been in God's presence. Y'all sitting here worshiping something that's like, you making it up. It's not even real, where we got something real. And so that's what I'm telling people.
And why they made it up, because for 400 years, they had a program.
Yep. They were in Egypt following the program. So Maul, and maybe I'll share it one day, but I shared with Maul a note from my daughter yesterday. Mm. Bruh, let me tell you something. That's more important to me than anything in the world. And the fact that my daughter is 26, she just turned 26. The letter to me, Maul, was like, I'm not saying I could die tomorrow, but I can leave this earth knowing that my daughter gets it. Mm. Like, the type of letter she wrote as an adult, it's like, okay, yep, she gets it.
Yep.
And she prayed, man, Dad, I pray that God give you long life, because I can't wait for you to enjoy your life, because your life has been consumed with blessing other people's life.
Yep.
I'm like, my daughter get it. Mm. My daughter like, man, I hope God give you another 40. And I love how she put it. Even if you don't care for you, I pray that God cares for you in the way you care for people.
Wow. Mm.
You know, so I'm like, yep, she got it. She gets it. You know what I'm saying? It makes sense. She's seeing this and not going, I hate church. I hate what church has done to my father. I can't, all these years, he was out doing this, he was out doing that, and he wasn't there for us. I'm geeked that my daughter saw the life we lived and we gave to Christ, and now my daughter is going to be a licensed therapist. When she come for money, it could have been whatever she wanted to be. Mm. So the fact that my daughter's like, yep, I'm about to go get, my dad did it, but I'm about to go get licensed. Mm-hmm. So that is structure, and I got you. And what it remind me of when I read the letter is, I don't know if y'all remember the movie, it took me 2-3 times before I got it, The Book of Eli.
Yeah.
Remember the book? You saw it, Denzel. You got to see it.
Yeah, you got to watch this.
Crazy part about it was how it ended and how it started.
Yeah.
And when I look at Jada, I'm like, okay, it's a testament that you're not bitter with the church, that you're not bitter with me, that the Lord blessed it where me and Dee Dee didn't get separated. Because I was. I'm like Kobe. I'm obsessed with doing the Lord's work. I'm obsessed with it.
Yeah.
And the fact that I was still able to have a healthy marriage, and the fact that my daughter wants to get married after seeing all of this, after my son seeing all of this, and they still going, yep, we want to follow on that path. They not running from it, because you could run from it. Like, man, Dad was like, Dad is on the move. You know what I'm saying? Like, Dad, you know, and so I try to find the balance, whatever that means. But Tim Tebow said something that was deep. And I'm just saying this to all my Christian leaders. Tim Tebow said, the church is not about the do's and the don'ts, and that's what it's become. A lot of, you can't do this, you can't do that. He said, the church is about the dones, what Jesus has already done, and the life that he's already set us up with. And I was like, yo, that's dope right there. It's not the do's and the don'ts, it's what he's already done. And that's what I want the kids to experience. Like, and as a method to the madness, Frederick Douglass said, it's easy to bless kids than to repair men.
Right. Yeah, it's easy to repair broken
men. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, easy to be a blessing to kids than it is to
repair broken men. You were Paul murdered.
No.
It's easier to build
strong children. It's easier to build strong children than it is repair for a rich man. E, right here, dog.
Poor man.
It's easier to build strong children
yeah.
than to repair broken man.
Through the needle of a haystack.
I want the knife.
Well, give me the knife.
Give me the knife.
Man, shout out to Organifi, man. Organifi.
It's easier to build strong children than fix broken men.
Yeah. No, that wasn't what you said.
No, to repair broken men, bro.
That's what he said.
Exactly.
You said beauty is in the eye of he who beholds the haystack of the man through heaven and manna.
Hey, man, where'd you find it?
His father.
Oh, bro.
His father.
Organifi. Shout out to Organifi. Man. Go to Organifi. Organifi.com. Promo code SUCCESS. All right? And get 20% off your order. On us, man. We giving y'all a little discount for your own health. All right? This is for you. So go to Organifi, man. Carl was supposed to bring some. He said he got rid of it. Because I told you, Fat just texted me. He was like, can you bring me some Organifi?
I'm talking about even my stash law.
Yeah, and Carl was like, man, I only got... Carl was like, no. He texted me, said, no. I only got four packets left.
I literally
left.
Got four packets. So, I was like, I thought I had another box downstairs. Oh, I was going to bring
no,
it.
No, for real?
Yeah, Carl, you know,
oh, praise right God.
Dang. You know Carl.
Carl, what?
I only have four.
Yeah.
I can't get none up to the pregnant woman.
No, Carl would have said, no, you ain't getting Mark. I would have been the happiest person on the planet. Okay, just so you know.
Hey, I tell y'all one number, just start cussing all y'all.
All right, I'm ready.
Leave me the blank alone. Bro, don't call
my
phone.
Just make sure you get everybody else too. Not just us. You know what I'm saying? You got the pastor that one time. Yeah. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, he got his
the one man who saved Eli.
He cussed him out.
I said, Carl, that's when keeping it real go wrong. I was begging Carl for 2 years to charge up. Somebody.
Yeah.
And he waited
when he finally did it.
The man of God.
Veteran.
My man
fought in two wars. He fought in two wars.
My man fought up at the crib.
Carl didn't give you no love.
Said, let me get them DVDs. Yeah. That boy Carl said, you cassettes. Get these DVDs when I get my mother money.
Was it DVD?
It was DVDs, bro. She's right.
Oh, that boy, he was like, Carl. He said, yeah, your video guy, man, he's pretty tough.
Fought in two wars, bro.
And save E life. We told Carl to charge every random person in the world was hitting Carl up for work. Carl was doing weddings, funerals,
everything.
For free.
I was like, I'm done. Whoever comes here next, y'all about
to
get it.
Next.
My man like, knocking the door.
She didn't give him the
how much did you charge?
She didn't,
I don't even remember, bro.
She didn't give him. You know how, you know, when you grew up in the hood, like, you don't touch the pastor's car. She didn't give him car went straight after
the pastor. I didn't figure that was the time when he was going boss up. I was like...
Carl bossed up on a man of God.
After the week of prayer.
After Carl listened to his sermon all week.
All week.
We're in charge of you
in a tent, bro. We outside in a tent.
In a tent.
Hot.
Yeah.
Dang. We had some times, dog.
Yeah.
We should write a book. We should do a movie.
We should do
BTC.
A movie.
Yeah. We got a couple coaching with E.T. questions. I can't even think of the right name. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if you're up to answering a few or...
I'm always up to answering a few.
I know you got your bride next door waiting on you. We didn't...
Yeah. My bride might be at the church working now. You know, she back at home, bro. She love that church.
I could always pick up where you leave off at, bro.
Okay.
Coach. I'll be your assistant coach.
Listen, man, a lot of you are not reaching your full potential, and it's because you don't have a coach. All right, we talked about it, man. A coach can push you in ways that you can't push yourself, give you information, blueprints that you can't get yourself. This ain't like no scratching no lottery ticket. You know what I'm saying? This is actual information that you can use to apply to your life. Go to coachingwithet.com right now. Coachingwithet.com. And E can be your personal coach. Imagine being coached by the person that coaches all of us. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's been coaching me and Carl forever. It's funny, when me and Maul went to the house where Jazzy had her Sweet 16, he was like, man, this is where I was watching Thank God It's Monday. This is where I was watching. This is where I found E and was like really being coached by E. Don't leave him hanging now.
Oh, no, no. I was you know trying to envision.
No, like, he was like, this is where I was
being. Yeah, that's crazy.
Like,
as soon as I came in.
Yeah, he was like, this is where I was being coached by E. And you had an opportunity to be coached by E as well. CoachingWithET.com. Go there right now. Sign up and join the community, man. All right. Let's see. this is actually from Jennifer. She said, how do I have a relationship with somebody in business who constantly creates justifiable conflict that affects the team you're responsible for without losing your cool?
Is she the peer or is she the boss?
It's just a question. So she basically saying a relationship with someone in business who's creating conflict. And it's affecting the team. I don't got context.
Yeah, I'm just saying, if I had context, because I could say if she was a CEO, what she could do, or if she was a superior, what she could do. But I'll make this suggestion, because either way.
I'm assuming she's a peer, I would say, because I wouldn't think.
Well, if she can't fire him.
Because that's what I'm saying.
She can't fire him, then if you can't fire him, I think what you need to do is, if you really love them and you love the company and that person is stopping the company from going to the next level, you probably need to start doing some research or some homework around dealing with personalities like that. I would say personally, I ain't gonna lie, if I could be a little selfish, I would say extremeexecution.com. And I would say if you could learn about their profile and understand who they are and understand why they do what they do and get some strategies and techniques to kind of help. Because sometimes, you know, conflict at the job is something deeper. It's like something that you learn at home or something that you're going through. And when you come to the job, you know what I'm saying, you don't really know how to.
Yeah, and I'm going to say this. I'm coaching with CJ.com. listen, I'm going to tell y'all, sometimes I get a bad rap for being too aggressive or whatever. Bruh, say something. Mm-hmm. Can we start there? Because, a lot of times, people don't even say nothing. It's the craziest thing.
I think they don't say something sometimes because they feel like it's going to be more
But I'm telling you, sometimes people just need to be called out on their stuff and let them know, bro, I see what you're doing. It's not cool. You need to relax. Mm-hmm. So I would just say, you know what I'm saying?
If you ain't talking to nobody. Yeah, I would say, do what you're saying, but get the information. So when you say it, you're not saying it from an emotional place. You're saying it from an informed place. You
know what I'm Nicole says, love the pod, love what y'all was talking about. What's the quickest way to unlearn and install the new program? What's the quickest way to do it?
Coaching with Jamal.com. No, for get with somebody that is where you want to be and learn from them the language, the rules, the rules of engagement, the code. So being with Maul, you might think it's random, but it's a system. And then the crazy part about being with Maul is that every time I'm with him, it's reinforced. Because I think you can learn something, but if you're not around it, it's like lifting weights, Maul. I mean, while the Lord has blessed you, if you stop working out for a year, you don't get the benefits of the last however many years you've been doing it. So in order for you to stay buff, you got to keep working out. And so I would say that's why coaching is important. So not only can I get it from Maul, but I need to stay with Maul. Mm-hmm. I need to stay in his presence. You know what I'm saying? Bruh, y'all going to be shocked. I don't even know if, Maul, you can recall it, but I called you the other day. You remember what I asked you?
I don't.
I just randomly call you and ask you a question.
Bruh, we talk a lot. I'm not sure.
All right. I called Maul. It's like, is there anything?
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yep.
What did I say?
Yeah. Is there anything you got in your spirit, a word you got for me?
Anything you could teach me today?
Yeah, you sure did. Yep.
You feel me?
Anything I could teach you today? Coaching with CJ.com.
You sure did. So,
yeah.
They sleeping on my kid. He never called me and said, you got anything to teach me? You feel like you know everything.
You taught me. Okay, you already taught me.
Yeah.
And so I just called Maul and was like, yo, anything you can teach me.
Yeah.
And then Maul was like, actually, yes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I was like,
surprise. Maul had something.
Well, it was something that I was going through. It was current. Yeah. And it was going through with the thing that,
surprise,
doing at the house.
Surprise. Yeah. Make sure you put that in there.
I actually have a question in here for Maul. I just looked. I said, dang, I got a coaching with Jamal question. Nia said, given how high the current interest rates are, do you think it's a good time to buy your first house when it costs considerably more for a mortgage than rent?
Now, look, Yes. Mm. This is a great time to buy. Mm. And it costs considerably more for your monthly mortgage payment, right? Mm. Because the interest rates are high. Mm-hmm. But the overall cost of the house is lower because the demand is not as great. All right? Mm. So this is a game of supply and demand. And right now, the supply is great. There's a lot of properties out there that's for sale, but there's not a lot of people purchasing properties right now. So which one would you have, Mia? Would you rather how it was when interest rates were low, where you had 20 people bidding on the same house and overbidding $20,000, $30,000, $50,000? Mm-hmm. Or would you rather get the property for $20,000 to $50,000 less, right? Get it less because you can now.
So now you can say it's $50,000 cheaper than it was.
It's $50,000 cheaper than it was. And it's not many people bidding on this house. So you can actually go a little bit lower, right? Maybe add in closing costs. So now, most people, though, when they purchase real estate, they're looking at their paycheck. They're looking at what their monthly payment is.
Not the cost of the house.
And not the cost of the house, which the cost of the house is directly connected to the equity that you'll have or you won't have.
Right.
Where the monthly payment of the house is directly connected to your paycheck. So I always
say, marry the
property.
Yes.
Date the interest rate. You can always refinance the property. Like,
Coaching with Jamal.
Coaching with the King.
Yeah,
Let's go coaching with the King.
I'm an assistant coach, man. This is my assistant coach. One day I'm gonna have my own team, but right now I'm assistant coach. I'm learning.
Coordinated. Yeah, and you also need to put your. You said that you need, in order for maintenance, you need to stay in the community.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, that's important, and that's what we have.
Because you keep going back to the pro.
Oh, for sure.
And this is why people get frustrated, because you come and you learn, but then you go back to the program.
Well, that's most people, right? Like, bruh, everybody knows, again, I always say, it's not one person in the world who don't know how to lose weight. Mm. You know how to lose weight, bruh. You know what I'm saying? Like, when you really, like, when it boils down to it, it's like, it's not one person who's confused as to, like, what, you know, like, as you sitting here eating your pizza. You ain't just like, yo, how you,
you know, but
yo,
you
how you lose? Like,
taking small bites don't
No,
work.
I'm just saying, you know. I'm saying. So No, but I'm saying, and the difference is, are you accountable?
Yeah.
You know, and I think that for us, that accountability is crazy. You know what I'm saying? It's like, yo, you literally know you about to come around other people who going to ask you about, are you working out? Are you eating healthy? Are you doing these things? You know what I'm saying? And being in the community, for those of y'all who don't have a community, that's why I always say you need to join a community. Coachingwithet.com. Just being around other people or getting information on a regular basis, because left to your own devices, man, it's tough. You know what I'm saying? Like, and we hold each other. I told Carl, I almost cussed you out. I said, listen, we was talking on the reg. I said, you're going to Barbados. Don't disappear on me. And I said, Carl, I was like, almost a whole week we didn't talk. And I sent you a text, and I was like, yo,
sure did.
I will fly to Barbados and put hands
bleep, with bleep, 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 bleep.
Straight up. Because I'm like, yo, we just got to be accountable to one another. And I was like, yo, I don't even want nothing.
That's good.
I just, like, I just got to make sure you doing what you're supposed to be doing. I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing.
And yo, coach, I was going to say, brother, piggyback what you're saying. Coaching takes it to the next level. It's only so far you can go on your own. I promise you with this.
Yeah.
We did a little demonstration right before the pod started where I asked Carl, I was asking him about, he was telling me that he was working out. I said, Carl, when are you going to get you a trainer?
Mm-hmm.
And then when you going to get you a coach? And then Carl was like, well, you know, I'm working out on this. I said, bro, you can't kick your own butt. I said, try it.
Mm-hmm.
And I had Carl, like,
did you say butt?
I did say butt. I said butt. I'm in the house of the man of God, bro. I said butt. Bro, I respect.
Ass in the Bible.
I said, kick your own butt.
I know that scripture.
And he couldn't do it. You can't do it, bro. It's a, you know, you need a coach, somebody to help push you to that next level. That's the only way you're going. If not, I can guarantee you're going to look exactly the same next year. And if you're okay with that,
you know
that,
why people don't want a coach? Because then you know you got to be accountable.
You
got
to be accountable.
You got.
You have
man,
to.
Man, you're going to have to. The coach like, all right, we meeting up there at 5. You like, yep. Ooh.
Well, that's why you got to pay for a coach.
Uh-huh. Because
when you don't pay, you're not necessarily holding yourself to that same.
Bruh. Yeah. And so much.
I think more than that, because to Mal's point, I can go to the gym consistently. Mm-hmm. I can hold myself. I made a commitment to Carl. I promise you, I'm going to go 5 days a week unless something crazy happens. I can.
What did Tamisha say? What did Tamisha say? Hey, I want you to stay at home today.
I'm doing it before she wake up.
Okay, all right, good.
So I'm saying that's not a problem.
Good.
Like, not a problem at all. But to Maul's point, I can still only go so far.
Yeah.
Even with my own commitment, discipline, I can still only go so far.
Bruh. And I said it last pod, and I was talking to Toby. We had an issue. Somebody just wasn't handling their business like that, right? Like, showed up late. You know what I'm saying? Like, this person just started. And, you know, Toby back shooting for the show. And it's supposed to call time 6:30 a.m. Person get there 6:40. All right, cool. And I'm like, yo, it's crazy because... And I was trying to say this in the nicest possible way. You're not sweet enough to be late.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And I said this before, and I promise you, I don't mean this as no shade, because Day-Day, Draymond is a Spartan legend. But my man, I said it, ain't really no hooper like that, and he going to be in the Hall of Fame. My man going to the Hall of Fame, and I promise you, yes, I'm saying, of course, he's a good basketball player. He's in the NBA. 90% of his Hall of Fame is going to be because he got dog.
Dog, that's it.
And he controlled the controllables. And you could say whatever you want about him. Oh, he rowdy, he this, he that. Bruh, my man done maximized every single ounce. Mm. Bruh, he playing defense against Joker. I'm watching Draymond play. He guarding Joker. I'm like, bruh, this man 7 foot something. One of the best players to ever play, and they got Draymond guarding him. Not because he the fastest, not because he could jump high and block. Like, dog, he maximizes who he is. Mm. And I'm like, dog, if Draymond can make the Hall of Fame hooping, how much more do you have in your tank? Like, for real, just as a human, like, yo, how much more do you have in the tank? Like, I didn't say you had to be the best. I didn't say you had to be, Draymond ain't built like LeBron. Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, I promise you, I don't know if he ever just tomahawk from the free throw line on somebody. But my man's still going to the Hall of Fame, and I'm looking at people right now, and I'm like, yeah, not only are you not going to the Hall of Fame, you didn't even make the league. Mm. And it don't have nothing to do with your skill set. It's got to do with you not controlling the controllables, and that's what a coach does. A coach allows you to maximize who you are.
Yeah, and then the thing is, too, and I want to say this about Draymond, it's crazy that you would say that because I'm like, wow, he's really maximizing.
Oh, bro, he a dog. Bro, my favorite player, he a dog. Yeah,
but let me say why this is crazy. When I say he's maximizing to the point that he's even willing to play a villain.
Oh, bro.
Okay, I didn't know how to explain.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
You feel what
Thank
I'm saying?
You. Whatever it takes. But I'm saying because... I know Draymond on Michigan State, and that's not who he is.
Bro, not at all, bro.
He ain't none close to that
he
person.
He was never close to that.
Like, thank you for saying that.
I'd say that and I've been around the program for a while. I'd say Draymond was probably the nicest.
Legit.
Oh, he's still a nice guy. Yeah. But think about this, though. When you say willing to play a role, right?
Yeah, he's willing to play
What's the knock? If Draymond's not on the Warriors, what's their knock as a team?
They don't have that
bravado.
Yeah. I mean, Curry, dog. I mean, Curry obviously one of the best players ever played.
Not a dog. Like, but...
No. I'm saying hooping. You know
okay.
What I'm saying?
Right. Skill.
Crazy.
Rise.
Yeah.
Clay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, but the reputation was.
They
I think it got something to do with them being light skinned. Yeah.
I
don't like that stereotype.
Most light skinned guys are soft. You know what I'm saying? They just soft. They got soft hands and soft butter. They're soft butter. I'm just saying.
But it's me though.
So Draymond. You know what I'm saying? Draymond got that dog.
He ain't quite over there with y'all.
Oh, bro.
I can go both ways.
He in the middle.
He in the middle.
I can go both ways.
He can go both. Yeah, he in the middle.
Yeah. So I'm just saying, when you know him as a person, that's like, wow, he's willing to even...
And I love it because people be out there...
Maximize that.
Oh, my God, Draymond, he's so out of control. I was like, oh, okay, 4 chips.
He's in control.
I'm saying
he's
very much
in got 4 rings.
Say what you want. He's in control of what he's trying to.
You got no rings, and you telling somebody with 4 rings how they supposed to.
Yeah.
He shouldn't be doing that. I don't know what he's supposed to be doing, but it's working. And my love language is results.
Yeah.
I'm just being real.
And he's what I said earlier, he does not care about others.
Oh, no.
And what they think.
No.
He's caring about, if I execute, this is what it's going to mean for my life.
And I don't care if I score 3 points.
Absolutely.
I don't care if I score 10 points. Like, I'm not even on that.
But I also say, this is why you just don't need a coach. Because if you get with the right coach, then you're going to be with the right team. Mm. So imagine Draymond on another team. He got Clay.
Yeah.
He got Steph. He got Iguodala when he was there. Like, he's had people there that were great in what they do and not as rubbing off on him. So, of course, if Stephen is the best ever and you playing with the best ever, practicing with the best ever, that's going to do something for you. And that's what people don't realize, too. Like, yo, it ain't just getting to know me or whoever, it's also the community that you coming into. Yeah. Like, you coming into a community of dogs. Mm-hmm. You come in the community where, what did we say? Somebody came to CJ after a conference, was like, C, bro, I'm struggling. C was like, what's up? What did they leave, their wallet or their computer? I think
it was Next Level. Yeah, you were talking about that. Somebody left their bag.
No. Somebody left their wallet.
They left their wallet.
Yeah.
So they came to see, like,
panic.
I left my wallet. And she was like, bruh.
Relax.
This ain't good. That kind of community. Somebody
this ain't that kind of community, bro. We went right to the back. They was like, you have wallet. All the money, cards, everything in there. Right.
I'm just
like,
saying, bro.
We don't attract that kind of
people. We don't attract
bro.
Those kind of people, bro.
I promise you, ain't coming to no conference of ours and trying to catch somebody
right,
slipping.
It just don't work
it
like
ain't,
that.
I don't think it's ever happened.
No.
Yeah, so I'm
talking
saying,
about free events.
Yeah.
Nothing.
We ain't never had nothing come up missing.
We just don't have those kind of people coming to the event. So that's what you also want to be down with, because you don't want to be the kid that get drafted into the league and you the number one, but you around number 82s. And now you about to lose 10 games in a row, 20 games in a row. You feel what I'm saying? Like, it is what it is. But when you're around greatness, it just makes you probably greater than what you would have been had you not been around that greatness.
Hey, that was my call to action right now. I'm just being real. He said it to me years ago. I think, you said to both of us, I think y'all would have had good lives.
Yeah.
Like, no doubt about it, y'all would have had good lives. But, bro, being in this environment, I'm telling y'all, I'm transparent on the podcast. I wouldn't be here. Bro, I wouldn't be here. I'd have been working somewhere pissed off.
Back
I'll
in the
be
monkey
honest.
Lab.
Bro,
spanking monkey.
Spanking monkey. No, that's an old school one.
He wasn't spanking his
monkeys. Spanking them monkeys.
He wasn't spanking them. He just worked with the monkeys.
I would have been spanking the monkeys.
Oh, my God. But no, nah, real talk.
Bro, you know you was playing with the monkeys.
I was not playing with no dog or monkey.
How did you play with the monkeys?
I did not play with monkeys. No,
what, did
in any
what did you do with them?
No, my job was to. I dealt.
Carl,
let me go
Carl,
here.
Carl, let me go monkeys.
My job was to keep as a lab tech, to keep the environment sterile.
That's it.
That was my job.
So did you interact with the monkey?
Very seldom. In terms of...
So yes.
Very seldom. Feed them, put food in there.
Oh, so you was feeding them.
There was one...
Feed, okay.
You was feeding them. I'm not talking. You just put food... Like, I dealt with literally like the newborn monkey. So we literally would put a bottle of milk for them. Literally.
Did you ever play with the monkey?
I did not ever play with a monkey.
Did you ever touch the monkey?
So there was one... What are we even talking about? What are we even talking about?
Hey, we out of here. We love y'all. We'll see you next week.
I want you to focus on here right now. Don't you worry about when you get home. You make this, you concentrate on this opportunity. You don't worry about tomorrow. You concentrate on this opportunity with all your might, with all your soul.
Thank you so much for rocking with us as always, right? We don't take it lightly, guys. And we hope that we've provided transformation and not just information. We want you to become the best version of yourself, right? Make sure you check out the show notes to access all the important links and get your product discounts. Now, one favor we're asking of you, do us this favor. Make sure you subscribe and leave us a review on Apple Podcasts. We want to know your feedback and how we can serve you better. And if there's anyone that you think could benefit from listening to the show, please, I'm begging you, please share it with them. And remember, as E always says, if you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.